Post-operative instructions, expose and bond. Sometimes, the after effects of an expose and bond procedure are quite minimal, so not all of the instructions may apply. Common sense will often dictate what you should do. However, when in doubt, follow these guidelines or call our office for clarification at 713-665-9200. Day of procedure. First hour. All depending on where the incision has been made, keep gauze in place to control any bleeding that may occur. The gauze pack may be changed as needed. Exercise care. Do not disturb the procedure area today. Do not rinse vigorously or probe the area with any objects. Please do not smoke for at least 48 hours, since this may slow down the healing process. Oozing. Intermittent bleeding or oozing is normal. Bleeding may be controlled by placing fresh gauze at the site for 30 to 45 minutes at a time. The ooze may look more impressive than it really is because it is mixed with saliva. Do not be alarmed. This is normal. Swelling. Swelling is often associated with oral procedures. It can be minimized by using a cold pack, ice bag, or a bag of frozen peas wrapped in a towel and applied firmly to the area where the compress can be placed directly over site. You can apply compress on and off for the first 24 hours. Pain. Unfortunately, oral procedures can be accompanied by some degree of discomfort. Depending on the severity of the procedure, you may be given a prescription for pain medication or be instructed to use over-the-counter medications to manage the discomfort. It is best to take the pain medication before the anesthetic has worn off. Make sure to bring with you the medication that has been prescribed on the day of the expose and bond. Diet. Eat any nourishing food that can be taken with comfort. Avoid extremely hot foods. It is best to avoid foods that may irritate the expose and bond site. Steer clear of hard, crunchy foods for the first few days.